By the way, this outline, a lot of this stuff from the outline, they are strictly taken from the Code of Federal Regulations, and they are edited to try to make it easier to digest. So, with all those underlines, italics, of course, made by me, but they're just designed to be more user-friendly as opposed to reading this. And of course, they put in the context of customs broker exam. So next one is split shipment. Split shipment, separate topic on the entry, but you can, under certain circumstances, you can split the shipment. And if the shipment is split for the inbound products, the new transportation should be filed for the new transportation entry for the portions or portions forwarded. So if you decide to split, you need to file new entries. The most important one, however, is the one dealing with textiles. Customs examiners have asked at least several times on the customs broker exam this very question. Textiles, diversion of textiles product in the situation of the of textiles product, if you shipping jackets, if you shipping t-shirts, if you shipping jeans, blankets, any textile product, you really have to ask permission. When you have to ask permission, two things you have to keep in mind. Permission from who? Permission from the port director, number one, and permission of the port director of the port of origin where you filed the entry, where you filed the CBP form 7512, not at the permission at the port of destination, which you indicate on the entry where you filed it. So here is one question. When would the version of inbound shipment containing textiles or textile products subject to section so and so of an act as amended be allowed? When can you divert if you have a shipment from point X to New York and it's sold to Miami and it's textiles? What do you have to do? Well, you have to ask permission of the port director at the port of origin. Port director, port of origin. You see, on B, customs says the same thing, with the only exception of destination. If you go to the destination, it will be the wrong answer. So pay attention. Origin is a buzzword, and the port director is a buzzword. Assistant Commissioner of Customs, that's headquarters. They're too important for that. They have more global things to deal with. Upon the written permission of Commissioner of Customs, that's even more important, because Commissioner of Customs is a top, is the head of the agency, top person. Never is also not true, because this is an exception. So here goes the saying, never say never. Next. So we deal with transportation inbound. And transportation, the very word inbound implies that there is something being transported in under bond. And of course, whenever we have a bond, usually we have, what's the bond? Well, bond is an insurance policy. In case something goes wrong, customs can reach a handout and make sure that the customs gets paid. So the provisions for the bond are provided here. And what type of bond here? So transportation inbound usually deals with a type of bond which is called the custodial bond. And if the carrier comes to the port of arrival, comes to the port of destination, and upon taking something at the port of arrival, let's say X amount of packages, they delivered X minus 10 packages. And the carrier says, I do not know what happened. Well, too bad, because you were responsible for them. So the inbound carrier, shall be responsible for shortage, irregular delivery. Remember the irregular delivery. What's irregular delivery? the definition we talked about in the beginning, you have 60-day rule and you have a 30-day rule for inland shipment. So if the regular delivery took place, meaning more than 30 calendar days, that's a regular delivery and that's a violation. We saw that type of violation in the previous example. Or non-delivery. It never showed up. So custodial bond. And custodial bond would include a surety. Would be the type of bond under which customs can have its recourse. So the question the customs examiners can ask you is as follows. What is the type of bond that would cover an obligation to redeliver widgets when, during transportation, widgets were delivered to an unauthorized location? Well, we know that the location must be authorized. And the correct answer is it would be the basic custodial bond. What about basic importation bond? This is for consumption entries usually, right? International carrier bond that pertains to the steamship lines or airlines. Instruments of international traffic. Well, this is something like international shipping containers. Foreign trade zone operator bond. Well, this pertains to the foreign trade zone section. So, focus here is a 7512. Form 7512 is the most important document within the transportation M bond because this is the document one uses to make an entry. Another point is usually whenever the merchandise is transported in bond, there is a seal. And if the seal is broken, and there are various standards for seal, but if the seal is broken or there is no seal whatsoever, then the carrier is liable. If the seal is not broken and something was missing, then the presumption is that it was not there in the first place. So what type of liabilities can the carrier be liable under the circumstances? The liabilities, again, they come in the form of buzzwords. Shortage, failure to deliver, and irregular delivery. And these buzzwords have been tested by customs examiners as follows. Carriers are liable for payment of liquidated damages under the carrier's bond for any blank. And here's when the buzzwords would be helpful. Shortage, failure to deliver, irregular delivery. Which would be shortage, failure to deliver, irregular delivery. And if those took place, then the carrier would be liable for payment of liquidated damages. What's liquidated damages? It's a certain amount for which there would be a penalty assigned. Short shipments, shortages, and any allowances. So, when the merchandise arrives and something is missing, but the surety packages are subsequently received, you have to have a new transportation entry. Customs examiners have tested on this, so I included it there, and this is how it comes. If a short shipped merchandise from a shorted from a shorted inbound shipment is received, the merchandise can only be forwarded under new transportation entry reference to the original entry. And the way it would show up is usually when the manifest or the commercial invoice says one thing, and you open it up, you open up the container, and you begin what you call stripping the container, taking the stuff out, and you find out that instead of 10,000 markers, you only got 9,000. Where is the other one? Where is the remaining 1,000 markers? Well, remaining 1,000 markers stayed at the port of destination. If that is the case, then you have to file a new entry and IT entry and reference to the old entry. So, must it be entered for consumption? No, it can't be entered for consumption. Can it only be forwarded under customs supervision? No, it can, because it can also be entered for consumption. You can clear that 1,000 markers for consumption under separate entry. That's an option. Must be returned to customs prior to forwarding? No, because it's really in customs custody, right? So this is kind of irrelevant statement. And it must be consolidated into the original shipment for forwarding. No. I mean, I guess you consolidate it by putting it together, but in order to forward something, you do not need to consolidate it because the original shipment has been already forwarded, right, to the port of destination. So here, E is really the best answer under the circumstances. Now we get to the kinds of entry. So this is really important stuff. Kinds of entry. So transportation inbound has recognizes five types of entry. The most popular by far is IT entry, immediate transportation, also called immediate transportation without appraisement. What you do is you need to deliver a shipment from Los Angeles to New York, for example. You put it on a railroad, you put it on a truck, and you start delivering. You do not appraise the merchandise, you do not pay duties. You just take it from Los Angeles to New York, and you clear it, let's say, for consumption and pay duties in New York instead of Los Angeles. Warehouse and re-warehouse withdrawal for transportation is it refers to the entries that you have in warehouse A. It's been already brought to the warehouse, and of course we're talking about the bonded warehouse. And in the bonded warehouse, it is taken out for transportation. So let's say we have a warehouse in Los Angeles, and it sits in that warehouse in Los Angeles, but the product needs to be delivered to New York. In that case, you do not have to take it out for warehouse and clear it in Los Angeles. You can take it out for warehouse, withdraw it from warehouse for transportation to New York and clear it in New York as well. So it's really one of the same, except this one directly comes from overseas. This one comes out from the warehouse, being withdrawn from the warehouse. Warehouse and re-warehouse withdrawal for exportation or for transportation and exportation. Warehouse or a warehouse withdrawal for exportation or transportation and exportation. Let's see. This refers not to the product that is needed in New York, under my hypothetical. But it refers to something where you have, let's see, so this is the map. So this is the US, this is LA, Los Angeles, LA warehouse. And then instead of New York, let's say this is a border, right? It needs to go to Mexico City. Before it, think my map is off, but it's all right. I think this, well, LA is more like here, right? It's so, no. It's more like this, right? This is after the Civil War, no, after the war with Mexico, right? Of 1812, when was this? When Mexico lost the war and the United States took a southern part of land, like New Mexico territories. Anyway, this is, geography is not my strong point. But the, you have to be cognizant of the border. So from Los Angeles, LA here, LA, you need to take it to Mexico. And you're going to take it by transportation and exportation. If it's in, let's say, if it's on a borderline, let's say San Diego, San Diego.